Hi, I'm Leticia Barr from Tech Savvy Mama here at the Washington Auto Show 2015, where there are incredible vehicles on display. Well, I know we have a huge line of cars from General Motors.
Yes.
What should families be looking for when they're buying new cars in 2015 and beyond? I know there's a lot of new technology out there, but what are the key maybe three look-fors or five look-fors for families these days?
Well, I think first and foremost, and I mentioned this to you earlier, is before you even start shopping, put a pad of paper or you know, notes function on your phone and just kind of log how you're using the vehicle. Are you really needing those many seats? You know, maybe somebody bought a 7-passenger car because they thought they'd be driving the kids to soccer practice, and maybe you're not doing that. So do you really need that size of vehicle? It's a good chance you could probably get away with something smaller. And by doing an actual log of seeing what you're doing with the car, how many miles you're driving, what time of the day you're driving, can help you really refocus on what kind of car you should be doing. Not looking for that all-in-one vehicle that's going to do it all. The second thing is safety. Obviously, that's a huge component. I mean, speaking on behalf of General Motors, our least expensive car, the Chevrolet Spark, has 10 airbags in it.
Wow.
So, yeah, in a catastrophic moment, that thing turns into a cocoon, you know.
Amazing.
Just boom, fills you up. So safety is a big part of it, and I think you're going to see very consistent high safety scores because that's the price of doing business in the car industry today. And the other side of it is the propulsion. I know that sounds kind of technical, but stick with me for a second here.
Absolutely. I'm a tech blogger.
Then
our general audience about propulsion and what that means, because I know that that's a big innovation.
It is.
And different from people who, I know you said earlier, the average age of a car is 11 years. So propulsion may be something not that was so big 11 years ago when they bought that first car.
Even 4 years ago, 5 years ago, when you bought a car, you knew that you were going to the gas station eventually. When you use that first tank that you got with the car from the dealer, you're then going to a gas station. Today, I could buy a car that never goes to a gas station. I could buy a car that uses diesel fuel, so I have to make sure I use the right pump at the gas station.
Yep.
I could buy a car that drives electrically most of the time, like a Chevrolet Volt, but then when we're driving to grandma's house 200 miles away, then I'm going to put gasoline in it. So it's going to be a combination of those things. You may buy an electric car that just rarely uses gasoline.
Mm-hmm.
So there's all these different things, and I think that's what you learn from spending time with that log and finding, wow, I really don't drive 600 miles a day, you know? And by the way, folks, you're not. Your average American drives about 28 miles a day. So there's a good chance there's some new kind of propulsion, hybrid, plug-in, diesel, something that's really going to best meet your needs.
Absolutely. Well, I think that it's so interesting that you said earlier the average American has a car that's about 11 years old.
Yes.
Certainly, we've seen a lot of technological advances in the past few years.
Yes.
What's something that you're most excited about in the new line of Chevrolets for 2015?
Oh, wow. Well, I'm a bit of a gearhead, so I really love the new Corvette Z06 because it goes 0 to 60 in such a rapid period of time.
Too bad we can't test that here this weekend, right?
Probably. Well, at least it's not snowing out here,
right,
so we'd
true.
Have a chance. No, but we can't test that one. I think I'm most excited just about the degree of choice that we have.
So many things to see at any auto show, whether you come to the Washington Auto Show 2015 or you catch one at home near you. It's definitely a worthwhile experience, so thank you so much for your expertise and sharing why these are important things to do as a family.